Hello students, in this video lecture I'm going to discuss cover of elements of a special type of PO set, the power set of a set. Now what I'm going to do in this video is that I'm going to find out what are the covers of the elements of power set of a set, and I'll actually start with a specific example just to give you an idea of what kind of covers are there for elements of power set of any set X. A specific set we'll be taking in the beginning, and then using that example which I'll discuss in this particular video, we'll conclude a particular result using which you can find out covers of any elements of power set of any given set X. So starting with an example, before I start with an example, let me just recall the definition of cover. Although I have discussed the definition of cover in my earlier video on covering relation, but for the sake of this particular video, let me just define again what cover of an element in a PO set means. Now suppose you are in the PO set P less than equal to, and suppose there are two elements in this PO set X and Y, then the element X is said to be covered by Y, or the element X has cover Y. This is expressed by saying, by writing like this: X is said to have cover Y, or Y is said to be a cover of X, which we can write like this: Y is a cover of X. If what happens, if the following conditions happen: number one, X should be related to Y. This is one thing that must happen. Then X must be strictly related to Y, which means X and Y must be distinct. So you should have something like this. You can even write X is strictly related to Y rather than putting a less than equal to sign. This less than equal to means they are related, and X is strictly related to Y. This means that X and Y are distinct elements of the PO set P. And the third condition that must be satisfied is that there should be no element Z. There should be no element Z lying between X and Y. Then you should not be able to find any element Z belonging to the PO set P which lies between X and Y and which is different from X and Y. So this should not happen if Y has to be a cover of X. So this particular definition I have already discussed in my earlier video on covering relations. But just because we are going to use this definition in this video, so I have just discussed this again. Let me just again repeat. You say that X has cover Y, or Y is a cover of X, when the following conditions happen. And what are those conditions? If X has cover Y, or if Y is a cover of X, then the first thing is that X and Y should be related like this: X is less than equal to Y. The second thing is that X and Y must be distinct, which means that X must be strictly related to Y. They can't be equal. And the third condition that must be satisfied is that there should be no element Z lying between. You should not be able to find any Z lying between X and Y which is different from X and Y and it is lying in between. This should not happen. So which means that, in other words, this condition means that if you order the elements of this PO set about which whatever PO set you are in, so if you try to order the elements after X, just after X, the next element is Y. There is nothing in between, which means that if I draw the hash diagram, we have discussed the hash diagrams also in details earlier, and how do you draw hash diagrams when covering relations are given, that has also been discussed in my earlier videos. But if you are saying that in this particular case, if you are saying that Y is a cover of X, or X has cover Y, or Y is a cover of X, in that case, if you draw the hash diagram, just above X, Y lies. There is nothing in between. So this is going to happen if Y is a cover of X. So this was the definition of a cover for understanding. Although there is an alternate way of defining cover of an element, which I have already discussed when we were discussing covering relations. But let me just consider this particular way of understanding a cover, that cover of an element is something which is just above that. So if X has cover Y, then Y has to be just above X in the hash diagram. So understanding a cover like that, let me now consider a particular power set and I'll just try to explain to you what covers of elements of power set of a set R. So this through an example I'm going to explain, but then in the end we will just conclude the discussion with a general result which actually gives the covers of the elements of any power set, no matter what the set X may be. If you consider the power set of X, then you can find out the cover of any element of power set of X using that general result which I'll be giving in the end. So to start with, this particular example also has been discussed already in my earlier video, but just again, because we need this example for understanding the result which I have to give in the end. So let me take X to be 1, 2, 3, and if I consider the power set of X, which is the set of all subsets of X, because X has 3 elements, so the power set of X has 2 to the power, this number, 2 to the power 3 elements, which means 2 into 2 into 2, which means 8 elements. And what are those 8 elements? If we try to list out those 8 elements, this power set consists of all subsets of X. So there are 8 subsets of X. And what are those 8 subsets of X? One is the usual subset, the empty set, which can also be written as phi. Then you have sets, subsets consisting of single elements, 1, 2, 3. These are also called singletons. Then subsets consisting of 2 elements, 1, 2, 1, 3, and 2, 3. And the set X itself, 1, 2, 3. These are the 8 subsets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. These are the 8 subsets of X, or these are the 8 elements of power set of X. And now I want to find out, what is the cover of each element of this power set of X? So let me start with the empty set phi. So if you consider the empty set phi, then the empty set phi is and also we know that as far as the power set of X is concerned, we know that power set of X is a PO set. This also has been discussed with respect to the inclusion relation. Where how is this inclusion relation defined? If you pick up any two elements A and B of belonging to power set of X, because power set is a set consisting of all subsets of X. Power set of X is a set consisting of all subsets of X. So if A and B belong to power set of X, this means that A and B are subsets of X. And when do you say that A is related to B? You say that A is related to B if A is contained in B, or if A is a subset of B, or if A is included in B. So this relation actually represents the inclusion relation, or the relation is contained in, or is subset of. So this basically set is a PO set. This has been discussed already, and since it is a PO set, you can draw its Hass diagram. Hass diagram also we had drawn, and the Hass diagram of power set of X, one way of drawing the Hass diagram of this particular power set of X, which consists of 8 elements, was this. Again, this has been discussed already. In the form of cube, you can draw the diagram. So this is the way. And phi, because phi is contained in all the, phi is empty set, is that subset of X which is contained in all the subsets. So phi will be at the bottom, and X is that set in which all the sets are contained. So X will be at the top, and at this level, phi is contained in 1, phi is contained in 2, singleton 2, and phi is contained in singleton 3. Then 1 and 2, these are contained in this subset 1, 2. Then 2 and 3 are contained in 2, 3, and the last one is 1, 3, which will be here, in which 1 and 3 are contained. So this is the diagram for power set of X, which we have already discussed. And now again, from the diagram itself, you can see that phi is contained in 1, and so phi is related to 1. Also, there is nothing in between phi and 1, and these two are distinct also. So actually, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to find out the covers of Y. So if you want to find out the covers of Y, you have to look out for those elements which are just above phi. So just above phi, you have 1, and there should be nothing in between. And those, and a cover is always distinct from it, from the element of which it is a cover. So you can just see, as far as phi and 1 are concerned, phi is contained in 1, so phi is related to 1. Also, phi and 1 are distinct. Also, you have, there is nothing in between phi and 1. So phi is covered by 1, singleton 1. By the same argument, phi is covered by 2. And then again, phi is covered by singleton 3. Phi is covered by singleton 3. So these are the covers for 5 or the empty set. Now if you try to find out the cover for the singleton, this singleton element 1, then this singleton one element 1, immediately above singleton element 1 you have 1, 2, and also you have 1, 3, and also they are distinct. This one is contained in this, so this is related to this, both of them are distinct, there is nothing in between, so this is a cover of this. So 1 is covered by 1, 2, or 1, 2 is a cover of this, it's one and the same. 1 is covered by 1, 3 also, or 1, 3 is a cover of 1, so 1, 3. Then again the same way, 2 is covered by, again finding out the covers for the singleton 2, just above 2 you have these two elements, this one and this one. So, and also you can see that 2 is related to this, 2 is related to this, 2 is 2 and this element 1, 2, this set 1, 2, they are distinct. 2 and this set, this 2, 3 are distinct. And also there is nothing in between. So 2 is covered by 1, 2, and 2, this singleton 2 is also covered by this. You, instead of 1, 2, let me just write 2, 1. It's one and the same, because I want to explain this something about the covers. And again, this is 2 is covered by 2, 3, so I'm writing it as 2, 3. And then for 3, singleton 3, again by the same argument, 3 is covered by 1, 3, or you can even write 3, 1, and 3 is also covered by, or 2, 3, or 2, 3 is a cover of this 3. So 3 has cover 3, 1, and this 3, the singleton 3 has cover 3, 2. And then as far as this 1, 2, 3, this set X is concerned, you can see there is no element which is just above X, because X is the topmost element. So this element doesn't have a cover, X doesn't have a cover, which means that this element does not have a cover in the power set of X. This is an element without any cover. So in a power, in a PO set, anything can happen. You can have more than one cover for a particular element, as in this case for 5 there are 3 covers, for singleton 1 there are 2 covers, for singleton 2 there are 2 covers, for singleton 3 there are 2 covers again, and for X there is no cover. So you can have exactly one cover, although there is no element having exactly one cover. Every element is having either more than one cover, or as far as this element is concerned, there is no cover. So this is the case for power set of X, when you take X to be equal to 1, 2, 3. Now if you take a look at the covers, if you just take a look at the covers here, X is not having any cover, so I'm not considering that. So just take a look, for example, look at the cover of this one. If you consider this particular set, then this particular set can be written as 1 union 2. I'm taking this one is common in both of them, so I'm taking one separately, and this is 1 union 3. So there is a pattern that we are noticing about covers, and I want to show you that pattern which is coming for the covers. If you regard this as the set A, if this is your set A, then this cover is A union this element, where this 2 is coming from. Your set A in this case is 1, and if you take A complement is X minus A. If you are taking the complement of A in X, which is 1, 2, 3, A consists of only one element, which is 1. So the complement of A is the set of all those elements which are not in A, but they are in X, which means 2, 3. So this complement of A is 2, 3, and this 2 you can see is coming from this complement. So 2 is one element which is coming from the complement. Again, as far as this particular cover is concerned, again this is your A, we are regarding this as A. This is again your A, this is A union this particular element is coming from the complement. So in general here, for as far as this particular example is concerned, if what is happening is that if you are taking A to be an element of a power set of set X, this is the power set of set X, and the power set has 8 elements. So if you consider A as this, then the cover of A is coming out to be A union, in this case it is coming out to be A union, you can say B, the set B consisting of only one element, where is this B coming? B is coming from A complement. This is the case for this particular element 1 which I am regarding as A, and this is an element of power set of X. So the cover is coming out to be of this type. Now let me just observe this one. If you regard this as A, again this one can be written as what? This one, this is 2, and 2 is common in both of them. I am trying to find out the covers of 2. So 2 is common in both of them, so I can write it as 2 union 1. And this one I can write as 2 union 3. And if you regard this as A, if I am regarding this element of power set of X as A, then what is the form of cover? The form of cover is A union B, where this B is coming from. We know that the complement of 2, if A is 2, the singleton 2, what is the complement of A? The complement of A is 1, 3. So we can see that 1 is coming from this complement. And again, here this is A, this is A union B again, where this B is 3 and B is again coming from the complement. So again, you can see that the cover of A in this case also, in this particular case also, we observe that the cover of A comes out to be A union singleton B, where from where is this singleton B coming? This singleton B comes from the complement of A. So again, the same thing over here. This was for 1, this was for 2. You can just verify the same thing over here. This is 3 is common in both of them, and this second element 1, 2, this comes from the complement of 3. And then again for this one, if you regard this as A, then the cover of this is A union B. This is phi union B, where B comes from the complement of phi. And what is the complement of phi? The complement of phi is X, which is 1, 2, 3. So you can choose any element over here as B. You can choose 1, or you can choose 2, or you can choose 3. So there are 3 covers. So we can see. So this actually gives me what is the form of cover of an element of the power set of X. This is a particular specific example that I have taken, in which X has been taken as 1, 2, 3. And the power set of X had 8 elements. And if you pick up any element A belonging to the power set of X, we have just seen that these 8 elements, if you pick up any of the 8 elements, then these 8 elements will have cover of this type, which means that A will be covered by an element of the type A union B, singleton B, where this B can be chosen as any element from A complement, or this is X minus A. This is the complement of A in X. So this is the result, this is the pattern which we can see for the cover elements. So in general also this result is true, not specifically for the set X is equal to 1, 2, 3, which we have taken as an example. But in general also this result is true. If X is any set, the result goes like this. If X is any set, and if you consider the PO set, power set of X with respect to inclusion relation, then the result is that if you pick up A to be any element of power set of X, then A will be covered by B, and this B will again be an element of power set of X. So A will be covered by the element B of power set of X if and only if B, this cover B, is of the form A union singleton B, where this element B comes from A complement, or this is X minus A. So this is a general result which is true no matter what X you take, not necessarily 1, 2, 3, but whatever X you take, if you consider the PO set power set of X with respect to inclusion relation, and if you pick up any element A belonging to power set of X, then the element B belonging to power set of X will be a cover of A if and only if. If and only if means the result is true both the ways. If B is a cover of A, then B will be of this form, A union singleton B, where B belongs to A complement, which is X minus A. And if B is of this form, then B has to be a cover of A. If B is of this form, it is a cover of A. If A is covered by B, then B is of this form. If there is a element like this, then automatically it will become a cover of A. So this result is true both the ways. It's if and only if. And that is what I wanted to discuss in this video. So this video actually gives me a general result using which you can find out cover of elements of power set of any set X. So that was all about this particular video.